With Big Buildings Direct. We're at another two-car garage here in Illinois. This is a great size here if you're considering just parking two vehicles, need a little bit of extra storage room. We're gonna go over some of the features on the inside and outside. This is actually a 24-foot wide by 25-foot long. Great two-car garage. That way, when you're opening up your door, you're not dinging the one next to it. You're gonna see there's a lot of extra room in here. We're gonna go over some of the features that this client did, from the roll-up doors, the walk-in doors, and even the rat ledge concrete, which we do recommend. So let's go in, check out some of the features. On the front here, we do have 2 9-foot wide by 8-foot tall roll-up doors. This is a 9-foot high structure on your eave side. For the roll-up doors, once you get to that 9-foot tall or the 8-foot tall doors, they'll need 1 foot of clearance to roll all the way up. Since when we do the frame outs, we do what's called a garage door frame out. We'll cut out the exact dimensions you need, whether that's with one of our roll-up doors or if you source one of your own electric doors. We remove that load-bearing base rail. That's what equally distributes the weight of your building. And we move it up to what's called a header bar. But something this size, this is a 9-foot high structure on your eave height. And again, that's gonna be on a 312 pitch. So we got enough room for those to roll up easy, up and down. These are a great option if you don't want to have to worry about electric. For this structure, we do have the horizontal siding, which is probably, I would say, the standard siding. We can do the vertical like we've talked about in other buildings. This has more of a residential look, I'd say. This client went with the clay for the siding, and then the earth brown for the roof, and then the trim, which goes on the corners, around all the walk-in doors, windows, and garage door frameouts, as we'll see. But we only usually have about 15 to 20 colors to choose from, depending on what state you live in. And this client did a great job of matching his house just off of the limited color palette we have as well. We can install these structures on level ground, gravel, asphalt, or concrete. We're just gonna need to know ahead of time, so we bring out that right anchoring system to lock your building in place and meet those wind certification requirements, which we do certify all of our structures to meet or exceed your local codes. Here in Illinois, typically that's gonna be a 35-pound-per-square-foot snow load and 140-mile-an-hour winds when you're in the Northeast or maybe up in Michigan. Do check with your county and make sure you know what your local snow load is. For concrete, what we do love to see, it's called a rat ledge, has a few other names. But as you can see, there's a little notch where it goes down that we have our siding go down about inch and a half there. That just prevents moisture, critters from getting in. It's a great option, simple. And we do have those in the engineered drawings that we provide to you. Once we have an order on file, you hand that to any legitimate concrete contractor, they're gonna know how to pour that. The windows here that we have, 2-foot wide by 3-foot high, made in the USA, as you can see. These are a great option for bringing in ambient lighting, peek outside, see who's coming down the driveway, or even put an AC unit. We can always do custom frame outs there if you wanna source your own larger window or one that we don't offer. Very simple, they got a screen, open up vertically. They do come in that white grid. Depending on where you live, we do have a few different options for the sizes there. As you can see, that trim that we talked about, that earth brown, that's gonna go around the window as well. Very good looking window. And over on our walk-in doors, some of them we can do with a diamond or a square cut window, again, just to get some extra ambient lighting in there. But they're super simple. This one's locked, but just to show you, you can lock them if you don't want anyone peeking in. So we're inside now. Again, the dimensions of this structure is 24 foot wide by 25 foot long. Average car, you're looking at about 16 foot. What I always recommend before you buy any building, you know, put some stakes in the ground, pull up your cars, ATVs, motorcycles, whatever you plan on putting in here. It's gonna give you a good feel for how big you need the building to be. 24 foot wide is a great width for a two-car garage, as you can see. When you open up a door, you don't gotta worry about dinging the one next to it. You got extra room for storage, like we got a grill, some extra shelves, storage in the back there. That this is a good size unit for a normal two-car garage size. You can get away with a 22, 20 is a little bit tight. Best thing, again, stake it out and see what works best for your lot. So the skeleton or the truss system of your building is gonna be comprised of 2.5 inch by 2.5 inch galvanized steel tubing. This is gonna be spaced every 5 foot on center typically, and that is attached to a base rail. Again, that's what equally distributes the weight of your building. So that's where you wanna pour your concrete dimensions. For certification and also structural integrity of the building, you'll notice we do have some side bracing there, and then again at the top of the truss system there, depending on the size of your building, you'll go from a triple truss to a ladder leg truss system once you get up to the commercial grade buildings, which anything over 30 foot wide is gonna be considered a commercial building. So something to consider when you're looking at different size metal buildings. So if you're doing this on concrete, we don't need anything too special. We'll provide you with the engineered drawings so your concrete contractor knows exactly what to pour right the first time. We provide the anchoring system. These are called concrete expansion anchors. They'll hammer drill these directly through your base rail into the concrete. Those things spiderweb out to grab the concrete, lock your building in place, and also meet those wind certification requirements. Big Al with Big Buildings Direct, making sure you get the information you need to get the building of your dreams.